their children. Oh, the eldest went fishing with his father. The girl went to her meal and cooked some vegetables for dinner. And the two youngest, I sent them to their grandmother.
Oh, what a feeling. I wish the children can see how beautiful my daughter is today.
Your daughter? Oh, she's a new teacher now, Full Village, right?
Yeah.
In the market this morning, they talk a lot about your daughter, a young and beautiful teacher. But I wonder why she isn't working in Ho Chi Minh City with high salary. Did you force her to come back and work here because she's your only daughter?
Oh, no, no, I never. She wants to do that because she wants to help the children here have the illiteracy.
I don't know that word, but I don't care. In such a poor village, what can a teacher do?
My daughter can do a lot. She can teach the children how to write and read and learn a lot about the world.
You know, Grandma, poor people just need food, need money. They don't need the teacher. The only thing I can do is just accept this life and work to feed my children. They eat as if they were machines.
Oh, my God. Oh, Missy, hi.
Ma.
Take a look. This is my daughter. Hello. Oh, how beautiful she is in the Ao Yai. How much I love Vietnamese Ao Yai, little daughter.
Yeah.
Are you listening to me?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I sacrificed my whole life with our husband to work in the field. I spent all my savings for her to be a teacher. Now, don't you think? What a great job I did.
Yeah, I can see, but I have four children, and it's impossible for us.
Hi. Can I help you? I have talked to the school principal about you and your children. It's so sad. Why? Because they are not coming to school. I wonder why don't you let them go to school and why more and more families are doing that?
Oh, my daughter, I told her many times about that, but she's so stubborn.
Mm-hmm.
She could win a debating contest.
You know,
I am a farmer. My children will be farmer for sure. I didn't go to school because my parents didn't go to school. That's the way it is in my family.
Oh, no, no, now listen to me. You are the young mother of the 21st
yes.
century.
Mm-hmm.
People in Vietnam have changed a lot. So you still have time to change too.
Yeah, my mother is correct. You are their mother, so you can force them to do what they want, what you want. But it doesn't mean that you can take away their rights. Children also have their own rights.
Children having rights?
Yes, of course. Right to have a good education.
Your words don't make sense to me.
Let me paint a picture for you. Every day your children will go to school and smile happily with their friends. And after that they will come to you and tell you everything about their school, their friends, the teacher and the lesson. Isn't it right? Now have a look there. What can you see? Your children work very hard every day. From the dawn to the sunset. But do you see that happiness seldom appear on their face? Yeah. But if you let your children go to school, time goes by, your children will have a brighter future. And they will run to you and say, "Thank mom, thanks for bearing me, and let I go to school." Isn't it a good picture? And I think you should make it happen.
You think I don't know and don't want to do that for my children? But how can I get enough money for four of them? From the cheap vegetable every day, from such flooded field, my husband often whispers, pulling children is saying goodbye forever to the money.
Don't worry.
I think I'm not brave enough.
I will talk to him, don't worry about that.
He will tell you it's impossible. Our life is too hard.
Maybe at the first time you just send two of your children to school.
Can I?
Yes, I think so. And I will call for help from other people to help you, your children and other poor children.
Can you?
I will try my best. Don't worry about that. And I'm sure that your husband will see how happy your children are and how they can change their life.
Mm-hmm. But you have to promise that you will teach them.
Sure.
Let them become a teacher like you.
I promise, because I want to have all the children to go to school.
Okay, I will go home and tonight I will try to persuade my husband.
Thank you.
Oh, isn't it wonderful? One teacher can die. My daughter, I'm so proud of you.
Yeah, me too.